Welcome to virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshata Kale and today we will learn English. Come on students, we will move to the lesson.
English of Standard 6 and the name of the lesson is, can you guess children? Yes, you are right. The name of the lesson is A Kabaddi Match. Yes, students, it is about a school kabaddi match which featured some spectacular raids. I will tell you a summary of this lesson in short. Okay, you must have to read the lesson to enjoy every moment of this sport. The match was between the students of 9th A and 9th B. 9th A won the toss and the match began. 9th B was a strong team with smart players. But at the end, 9th A beat 9th B, who had never tasted defeat earlier. Because of their team spirit, their confidence, their strategies, their swiftness and suppleness. Okay, this is all about the lesson. Students, I will give you detailed information about Kabaddi and its rules. Who knows, if you make resolve now, one day you may help win glory for your school, district or even the state and the country. Isn't it? Okay, we will move further to know the information and get the rules. Kabaddi is an ancient sport. It originated in India and has now became popular in many countries, so that many international events are organized. In these events, international rules are followed. But several other Kabaddi styles such as Sanjeevani, Gamini, Amar, etc. are followed in different parts of India. In Kabaddi, two teams of seven members each face each other in a flat rectangular court divided by a midline. You can see in this picture. The game is usually played in two halves with a half time break in between. After the break, the teams exchange their sides in the court. Play the game, each team sends raiders across the midline to the other team. The raider tries to tag the opponents and run back to his side all in one breath. To show that he hasn't inhaled again, he has to chant Kabaddi, 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 Kabaddi all the time. If he has to inhale again, he is out. You can see in this, a black shirt wearing person is a raider. And all that other team wanted to catch him. The opponents try to catch the raider and stop him going back to his half till he loses his breath and has to inhale again. If the raider manages to go back successfully, all the persons he has tagged and all those who have touched him are declared out. You can see here, he is touching the midline so that all tagged persons are out. For each player declared out, the opposite team scores a point. If all the 7 players in a team are out, the opposite team gets bonus points. Alona. The team with the maximum points wins the match. These are rules of the Kabaddi. The game of Kabaddi requires good health, muscular strength, strategic skills, a lot of practice and, above all, great determination. Indian girls and boys have always excelled at Kabaddi. Now students, here list all the words specially used in the game of Kabaddi. You know that there are some special words that are only used in Kabaddi. We will list them out. Words specially used in the game of Kabaddi are raid, raiders, anti-raiders, tag, lona, and midline. If you read the lesson, you will come across all these words specially used in the game of Kabaddi. Okay. Now students, today we are going to learn about degrees of comparison. This is the grammar part and this is very, very important. Okay, please give more attention towards this. Degrees of comparison. Yes, students, here 3 types are there. Number 1, positive degree. Second one, comparative degree. Third one is superlative degree. Remember these 3 types: positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Now, when to use all this, we will see. First one, positive degree. It is used when only one thing is being described. Got this? Comparative degree. It is used when 2 things are being compared. The first, we are describing only one thing. In comparative, we are doing the comparison between the 2 things. He is taller than she. Like this, comparison will be there between 2. In the third one, that is superlative degree, here it is used when 3 or more things are being compared. Ram is a tallest boy in the class. Tallest, and in the class. See, all the boys are compared with Ram. Got this? Then we use a superlative degree. Okay, we will go through some of the examples. Then it will become clear for you. See here, 3 birds are there. First one, blue bird, is a small bird. That is a positive degree because we are only describing about that bird. That is, it is a small bird. When the yellow birds we see, then we say that it is smaller than that blue bird. Means we are doing the comparison between the 2 birds. So we say that is smaller. That is the comparative degree. Okay. The next one is a red bird. That is smallest among these 3 birds. So this is a superlative degree. Okay. Now one more example see here. Here young, younger, youngest. Here also positive, young, comparative younger and superlative youngest. See their ages. Next one, see the sizes of apples, big, bigger, biggest. See here the size of the elephant, big, bigger than, biggest. Yes, dear students, see here, these are all adjectives. If the adjective is small, then we add er when we are changing that one to the comparative degree, and we add est to make it superlative. Okay, and if the adjective is longer, then mostly we add more to the comparative and most to the superlative degree. Okay. Complete the following sentences using your own ideas. This is from your textbook, page number 17. Here three sentences are given, and we have to complete these sentences by using positive, comparative, and superlative degrees. We will move to first one. The princess was as dash as dash. Means we have to describe a princess. So I will put like this. The princess was as delicate as a flower. Okay, here we are thinking only about the princess. We are not doing any comparison. Got that? Okay, next one is the princess was dash then dash. See here, comparison is there. So we can write here the princess was prettier than her sister. Here comparison is in between her sister and the princess. Then it becomes a comparative degree. Here you can see er is added. The princess was the dash amongst all dash. See here, superlative degree we have to write. And you can see here the comparison is between the princess and rest all women. So we can write like this. The princess was the most beautiful amongst all the women in the country. Got this, students? Again, I will recall, positive is describing a thing. Second, comparative means there will be a comparison between the two things. And superlative means there is comparison between three or more things. Okay? Here, we will write the different forms of positive, comparative, and superlative. Okay? Good. Good is the positive form. Better, comparative, best, superlative. Remember this. A little different this is. Good, better, best. Bad, worse, worst. Okay? You have to remember this. Worse is the comparative form of bad, and worst is the superlative form of the bad. High, higher, highest. This is easy. Nice, nicer, nicest. See, these two are small adjectives, so we have added here er to comparative and est to make it superlative. Okay. Attractive, a longer adjective. So we are adding here more attractive, most attractive. Interesting, a long adjective. More interesting and most interesting. For these children, you have to practice more for these degrees of comparison. Okay, try to collect some more and make a list of positive, comparative and superlative degrees. Thank you, children. Now, students, I will suggest you one activity on this lesson. Okay, try to do that. From the internet or other sources, find the other names by which kabaddi is known in different parts of our country and the world. Okay, please try to do that activity. You will enjoy. Okay, take care. Stay home and stay safe.
Thank you very much, students, for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get new updated videos.